Yo, what is going on, everybody? It's your boy Ants Larmstrong back again. Today we are talking about my best tips and tricks for no money spent here as we now almost reach July here. We're fully into summer here in MLB The Show. Lots of new content. We made a top five tips and trips video for no money spent players or little money spent. Even if you spend a lot of money, you can probably find some tips for it. We made a tips and tricks video for that early on in the game's life cycle, but there's a lot of things that are new now. There's a lot of things that are different, and I think there's different areas to put in your focus, whether you're someone who's had this game for a while, or if you've just been picking up the game from the days of play sale when it was on sale and you're just getting your feet wet in Diamond Dynasty for MLB 20. I want to give you some tips and tricks on what you should be doing now to kind of get your team started, kind of get the ball rolling, and how to best capitalize on your time, whether you have limited time, whether you're still have a lot of time to play. Either way, you want to make sure you are able to be as efficient as possible and put a really good team together. As you can see right now, we're rocking the 97 overall team, all no money spent completely. Haven't spent any money on this game, and some of these cards even are free cards you get from the game as well. So without further ado, let's hop into it. So the first thing we're going to talk about is programs. Under this program tab right here, you have what is probably some of the absolute best rewards in the game. Now, we're not going to talk about the inning programs too much. Obviously, the rewards here are incredible, and you want to be doing these inning programs, but it's something that you're going to do a little bit more passively just as you're playing the game and as you're completing some of this other stuff. But definitely don't overlook these inning programs. Come in here and get as many stars as you can. You at least want to come in here, get your bosses. If you get them in a reasonable time frame, so far you can make about 60 to 70K from these bosses. Right now they're around the 30 to 40 range, which is still not bad, but they're only going to go up from there as we get into the next inning. We'll have a video coming out on that real soon talking about the fifth inning program. But even past 300 stars, lots of great rewards here. You can see stubs at each step, and then 5, 10, 10, 20 packs. Lots of rewards along the way here. 900 stars is a lot, but again, even if you're just getting to 300, you're doing really well with your rewards. But really, don't want to spend too much time talking about inning programs. What I really want to focus on here are these player programs. As you can see, we have completed every player program in the game right now, and the rewards from these are extremely significant. So in regards to some of these, you're going to get some insanely good players along with rewards. You know, guys like Jorge Posada are still some of the best. He's one of the better catchers in the game, even at an 85. You can see with the stats here covering up a little bit, but a switch hitter, 85. And not to mention, you're gonna get some stubs. You're gonna get three non-sellable Yankee player packs. So of course, if you have not completed the Yankee collection, you're gonna get a handful of silvers and bronzes to help that out. Same can be said for all of these inning ones. Same, you know, with Dawson, you're gonna get the Nationals. You know, Keith Hernandez, you're gonna get your Cardinals, so on and so forth. But you're gonna get those subs along the way. Now, a lot of these guys, I'm gonna be honest, they're not great players. You know, a guy like Omar Vizquel, even if you're just starting out the game, you're not, he's not, that power really hurts him. You're not gonna be using him too much, but what he does do is give you an all-star card. So with that, you're going to be able to go into your collections tab. Let's hop over to there real quick. So as you complete these player programs, you're going to be able to acquire cards to knock these out. For example, we're just looking at that Omar Vizquel. He's an all-star card. If we collect 10 all-star players, we're going to get 250 stubs, 3,500 XP. You get 10 of these, you know, you can find 10 of these cards for free, collect them all, and then you're done to go there. Same with the signature series. If you get the free signature series Jackie Robinson card, anyone can get them. Same with a guy like Sandberg from the XP or Warpath. You're getting 100 stubs, 1500 XP, and the free ball impact. So you're accumulating those cards that are going to help you knock out all of these collections, all of these missions. And with those, you're going to accumulate some more stubs along the way. Not to mention, though, with some of these player programs, you're getting additional rewards on top of it. Let's take a look at the Jackie program, probably the most rewarding overall. So it starts out pretty slow, but as you'll see as we get in, there's a lot of rewards. So we have packs, we have stubs, we have XP, more packs, we have the gold card, the bat skin, another item you can go in and throw into collections to get some more stubs back. You have more packs, the ball impact, the diamond socks, the five bundle, more stubs and XP, more stubs, another five bundle, stubs, XP, headliners, 10 packs. We have 2K XP. We got the ball in. We got another diamond card. stubs, packs. You can see the stubs and packs for this are significant. You got the 5 ball and bundle here at the end. You're probably going to get 5 golds from it, no doubt about it. But hey, if you're just starting out, 5 golds is 5 golds. It can help you out, put in some players on your team. Or you can go through, list them on the market, get some subs back, and potentially use them for collections as well. And then, of course, all leading to the 99 Jackie Robinson at the end, the 6 series Jackie. He's a really, really good card, especially as a no money spent player. I think he's the best no money spent option at second base right now. Him and Ryan Sandberg for sure, but you can move Sandberg to another position, have Jackie at second base and be doing really well. But you can see the packs and stub rewards are pretty incredible. Same with the Ken Griffey Sr., the Father's Day program as we come through here. More stubs, packs, XP, 2,000 subs at the end of it. You're getting 2 diamonds as well to fill out your squad. Decent players and nothing too insane. But again, the stubs, packs, XP, it all adds up a little bit here, a little bit here, a little bit there. In total, from these player programs, I did the math. We did the numbers. You're getting 16 free diamonds. Now, again, they're not all that great. You know what I mean? Vizquel, Austin Hernandez. I mean, a lot of these guys aren't insane, but you're getting 16 free diamonds. So if you're just starting out, any diamonds help. You're getting 76 packs. Around 10 of those are ball and habit packs. And then around another 5 to 10 are going to be headliners packs. So those packs with increased odds of pulling higher overall cards. You're getting 26,000 XP. That is 3 normal levels, just about, or 1 prestige level, give or take just a little bit. Of course, you're going to get more XP from playing the games it needs to take to complete these programs. But just in bonus XP, getting 26K and 46,500 subs. So if you haven't gone through here and completed these, you're leaving a ton of XP and stubs on the table, plus cards that you can use for collections. Even if you already have, for example, Vizquel, again, if you already have 10 all-star cards, you're done with that collection. Getting another all-star card will be beneficial for when those collections expand at some point and lead to higher overall cards. I'm fairly certain that at some point in the game, those collections will expand and lead to some very, very good high overall cards. So you want to be prepared for that. Other thing you want to look at as well, staying on the programs, are your monthly awards. All of these 3 each give you a high-end usable card at this point in the game. Not to mention, of course, you're getting stubs, you get packs, you get more stubs, you're getting other diamonds to fill out your lineup along the way. And then of course you're getting a guy like Cody Bellinger at the end, 97 overall, one of the best outfielders in the game right now, plus some bat skins. Again, more stuff for collections, more diamonds to add to your squad, and more stubs and packs to help fill it out in addition to that. So definitely come in if you haven't already. You want to knock out all 3 player of the month programs and every normal player program in this game if you're no money spent and looking to build up your team in the best way possible. So now on to kind of tip 1A, so to speak. This is going to go in conjunction with these player programs, and that's your moments. So a lot of these player programs, you have moments tied to them that are then going to help you complete the moments. As we can see, Jackie Robinson has a ton of moments tied to him that are going to help you complete the Jackie Robinson program. And for doing so, if you complete all these moments, you get 8,400 stubs and 2,950 XP. 20,950 XP. That is significant. You know, same can be said for all of these. 85, 94, 7,900. And then we go into the 4th inning program. Again, these are all tied to other player programs. They're going to help you out there. You're going to want to come in and do these as well. Couple thousand XP subs there. And then of course, as you can see for this one, we have 5 packs and 2,500 stubs as a bonus for completing it, on top of the 12,500 you get in the 6,700 stubs. So tons of rewards here. You definitely want to come in. Same can be said with Team Affinity. As you can see, when you complete these, you get a bonus 15K stubs. You get a bonus 15K XP and 5K subs. That is in addition to all the other rewards you get. So that's just a bonus for completing it. You can see I still haven't gotten stage 2 completed yet, but when I do, 15K XP, 5,000 stubs immediately. You definitely want to come in, focus on these moments, knock all these out. They're going to help you knock out other rewards. One thing to not overlook are the creative player moments. Even if you're not going to have a creative player for all of those, I obviously, as you can see, I've not completed them all yet. But you can see some stubs. These are all really quick as well. If we hop into one, you can see 3 hits in 3 games, 3 hits extra base, 1 extra base, 1 run. Pretty quick, and you're going to get 4,500 XP, 1,100 stubs, you know, 5,000, 4,000. You're going to get about 5,000 XP and anywhere from 1 to 2,000 stubs for all of these. It's not a lot, but it's going to add up over time pretty significantly, especially for every position. And then you also include what you're going to earn just from going in and actually playing the moment as well. You're gonna be able to level up rather quickly coming in and knocking out these moments. And of course, as you level up faster, you're gonna get more rewards on your XP reward path, reach that prestige XP reward path. As you can see, I am closing in on prestige 45, which is gonna guarantee us a 90 plus overall high diamond. Hopefully we can pull Trout, add another 250K to the bankroll to work with, to invest in the market, open some packs there, have some fun with. But definitely want to knock out your moments, be focusing on those for sure. One quick thing I also wanted to mention, in addition to the creative player moments, be sure you're coming in here, scrolling all the way down and coming to your creative player collections. As you finish these collections, you get pretty decent rewards. You can see the stubs you get from collecting 10 gold starting pitchers is 1,000. I think in total, people have done the math, you get about 30K from the bronze, the silver, and gold tiers from all these. So as you're going through and completing collections and getting non-sellable cards as you lock them in, you can still collect them a second time. So any non-sellable cards you have, if they're needed for another collection, you can still collect them. So come in here, collect these, pick up another 30K stubs or so. Be sure you're not overlooking these as well. You're not getting a lot, but hey, 1,000 stubs there, 1,000 stubs there, some XP. Those are going to help out. Same can be said for some of the other collections as well. So don't overlook your collections. Make sure you're going in there, completing the ones you can with cards that you already have that are non-sellable, and kind of double dipping up on your rewards. So tip number 2 that we're going to dive into here is conquest. Honestly, one of my favorite ways to get cards and rewards in this game. There's so many things to do with conquest, and I want to talk about some of the ways to make sure you're being efficient with it as well. As you can see, we have a ton of conquest maps. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 conquest maps. You want to come in and do them all, and I don't over exaggerate that in one bit. There are a ton of rewards. Now if you come in here and you look at the Father's Day and you come in here and look at it, you can't actually see the rewards since I haven't completed, but you're probably saying, only 7 rewards, it's nothing too crazy there, there's no packs, any of this. But what you want is the hidden rewards. So as you come into this Father's Day map, can't remember them all off the top of my head, but there's a couple of headliners packs, you're getting a ball and it's a habit pack, you're getting a quarterfinal players league pack, tons of packs in here. There's 2 ball and it's a habit packs here in the Mother's Day pack, the Mother's Day map. You want to come in through here and complete this. There's a couple prospect packs in some of these, which that's all guaranteed stubs. If you get a prospect pack, at worst case, you're getting 5K stubs. Best case, you can get 20 to 30K stubs, which again, if you're just starting out, is really beneficial. Not to mention more rewards, stubs, and XP for knocking out these missions. You're getting progress to inning programs in some instances. You get the 10 bundle for completing the Willie Mays USA map, and you get the prospect Tim Tebow for completing this one. Gives you another card for those prospect collections. I can't overstate enough how important doing these conquest maps are. Even if you may think it's a little bit slower, boring, don't necessarily have to do them all in one sitting. Pace it out a little bit. You want to come in here and do these conquest maps. In addition, though, while you're doing these conquest maps, you might as well be working on other things as well. So for the most part, you can play most of these conquest games on all-star veterans. So load up your team with one team, you know, make it all Nationals, make it all Dodgers, make it all Red Sox, whoever. Load up your team with one singular team's players, knock out some team affinity innings while you're doing it as well, or check out your dailies. Right now I have Pirates hitters as my daily mission. So if I was playing some conquest, I'd load up some Pirates hitters, play a conquest game, knock it out and be done with it. I may throw my creative player in there as well to get him some ABs in innings, help him get some hits so he can level up as well there too. So definitely make sure you're being smart and efficient with your time while doing these conquest maps. Be knocking out your dailies, be knocking out Jackie Robinson missions, be knocking out team affinity innings and missions as well, because you have the statistical missions tied to it. Be knocking all those out while you're doing conquest, getting those hidden rewards, getting those stubs, XP, packs, players, whatever it is. You get a lot through conquest. You can build it. If you just started today and came through and did every conquest map, you'd probably be sitting on a ton of stubs, a ton of packs, and the ability to pick a really good team together just from that. So the next thing we're going to talk about, one of my favorite things that they've changed here for MLB The Show 20, is events. and these cumulative event rewards. As you can see, we're sitting at 61 wins here in the Moonshot One, the current event going on. And I can't overstate enough and recommend getting these events done with and taking the rewards from these as much as possible. Now, obviously, online play is not for everyone. But even if you have not played a lot of online before, I think events is one of the best places to start playing online and kind of get a feel of it, especially with an event like Moonshot. With events, it's all free entry, so you're never going to lose any subs by playing. Your record is irrelevant. Record doesn't matter at all. It doesn't affect your actual record that shows up online when you play someone. It doesn't affect your record on the Show Nation or anything like that. No one can ever see your event record unless the event is currently live. And then three, there's usually overall restrictions that are going to help even out the playing field just a little bit. So, for example, this event has an 85 overall team cap. So, someone can't come in and just have an all 99 lineup and run through you if you're just starting out. And the rewards are significant. Even with this one, there are no player rewards, which is a bit unfortunate. A lot of them, you do have player rewards that lead to really good players. This one does not have any player rewards, but as you can see, as we scroll through here, there are a ton of packs and stubs. Pay attention to these XP at the bottom. 100, 500, 500 subs, two packs. We got three packs and 500, 1,000 subs, 1,500 subs. We got pack bundles. We got gold players. We got ballin' packs. We got prospect packs, which again, it's a guaranteed 5K each, up to 20 to 30K each. Plus, you know, bundles, pack bundles, more stubs, and XP, bundles. They got the quarterfinal pack, 7,500 subs, the five ball and bundle, and then your duck on the pond pack at the end, which is going to guarantee you some decent value there as well. Lots of guaranteed rewards and value here. And the best thing is with these cumulative events, you don't have to finish it before the first part of an event is over. As you can see, the first Moonshot event ends on the 23rd, this upcoming Tuesday. But if you don't have 100 wins before that, I personally won't, I'll be able to come on when Moonshot Southpaw time starts. My 61 wins will carry over, and I'll still be able to work towards the 100 win goal. Or if they expand it to more wins, I'll be able to work toward it there as well. You definitely want to be coming on and knocking these out. It is an absolute great way to come in, make progress towards these event wins, get a lot of packs as well. And another thing to think about is team affinity as well. Let's take a look at team affinity real quick and talk about how we can tie that into events. Again, talking about being efficient with our time and as effective as possible so we can accumulate stubs, packs, and players in a timely manner. So we're talking about team affinity here. So let's take a look at my personal favorite team, the Texas Rangers. As we come on here, we can see there are some statistical missions that you can knock out to give you more progress. So this one is innings with Rangers. Rangers have a couple of bronze pitchers, which are eligible for this event. And as you can see, pitch 40 innings with them. I can load up my team with bronze Rangers and common Rangers pitchers. Pitch 40 innings with them. I'm gonna get an extra 5 team affinity points for stage 1. Same can be said for stage 2. We have home runs with Rangers and online home runs with faces of the franchise, Joey Gallo. That is going to give me a total of 10 team affinity points. Same can be said for every team. So every team obviously has their face of the franchise card, and there is a statistical mission with those tied to it to get more for team affinity stage 2. So if you're needing, I mean, that's an easy 10 team affinity points. So I have to do one less exchange or one less showdown or whatever. That's going to help out. And of course, the same can be said for any team. Look at the Orioles here, go to stage 2, and we can see extra base hits with Orioles outfielders gives you 7, and extra base hits with Trey Mancini, face of the franchise, that is going to give you 5. So if we come on, do all those, that's going to get us an extra 10. That would actually boost us up to 45 of 50, and then I'd pretty much almost be done with the Orioles team affinity. So an extra 10 team affinity for every team out there, not to mention you're going to be accumulating these innings as well, but an extra 10 team affinity for every team out there, something you definitely want to focus on. Team affinity 3 is going to be around the corner real quick, which takes me to my next point. A great segue here. Focus on your team affinities. There's a lot of them, and it's daunting, especially if you're just starting the game. It can be a lot to get through. I must be honest, it can be a lot. This is the first time we've had team affinities really be expanded to the level that they're at. In previous years, you know, and it'll be 19, for example, the team affinities ended at what is essentially here after you getting the diamond player, and then that was it. There was no more team affinity for the rest of the year. This year, they've expanded it once. They're going to expand it twice. And then they're going to finally expand it a third time. There are going to be some incredible rewards here. So not only do you want to get these teams done and prepared for Stage 3, which is going to be coming soon. As we can see, Stage 3 is coming in the summer. It's officially summer here. June 20th was the first day of summer, or the 21st, whatever. It's officially summer here. Summer's coming. It's right around the corner. Stage 3 is going to be here. I'm predicting the first or second week in July. Stage 3 is going to be dropping. We're going to get some incredible cards with these. I'm guessing 95 to 99 overall cards within this. But not only do you want the player cards, you also want the rewards along the way, which can't be overstated. So as you come in here, we're looking at the Cubs, for example. So again, you're going to get that non-sellable Cubs pack, and you're going to get the Cubs stadium. So if you go through, do every team to here, go through, collect your MLB stadiums, you get a little bit of subs back from that. Then you're getting your non-silver pack. So if you haven't done the collection yet, you get the two silvers, two bronzes to help you collect there. You're getting 2,000 subs. You're getting the gold prospect. And then as we come along, the team affinity, which these team affinity packs are no different than just normal show packs. Have the same odds, 1 in 50 diamond, 1 in 10 gold. Same odds as normal show packs, just rebranded B team affinity. You get the same amount of items. You get the same amount of players. Nothing is different with them. And then, of course, you're getting the diamond player. Gonna help out the team. You're getting another 4,000 subs. You're getting another 6 packs on top of that. You're getting another 3 packs. Add in a bond pack. Add in 3,000 subs, and then add in a 90 plus overall future star card. You are getting a ton of rewards for team affinity. And you know what we say, as you extrapolate that one out over 30 teams, that is a ton of rewards. 60 diamonds total, an obscene amount of packs, stubs. There's so many packs and stubs that you get from Team Affinity. Honestly, in addition to these player programs, Team Affinity is an insane grind this year. It has been the absolute one of the best things they've added to MLB The Show 20 in order to make the game better for no money spent players, more feasible to approach. If you go through and bust out all your player programs and all your Team Affinities, you're going to be sitting on an obscene amount of stubs, XP, and players. You're going to be busting out collections. You're going to be obtaining 99 overalls through the XP reward path. You're going to be completing divisional collections, league collections, everything. You are going to be rocking and rolling. If you come in here, take the time and bust those out. Throw in some conquests, throw in some ending programs. Next thing you know, month down the line, month and a half down the line, you're chilling with Micky Mantle. No money spent, no problems, no worries. And you're doing great things. So the last thing I want to talk about here is the marketplace and your inventory, and make sure you're being proper with that. So we talk a lot on this channel about how to make stubs on the marketplace. So if you're new to the game, or if you've never really worked the market, never done flipping before, never done investments, definitely be sure to subscribe. We have a ton of content. Kind of our main thing here is content about working the market, capitalizing on the market, and how to make as many stubs as possible. So for example, let's filter through, let's look at a live series card here. This is something we talked about last week in a video that we made in preparation for the new Ducks on the Pond pack coming out, the Father's Day program and the Jackie Robinson program. We talked about investing in the market. Let's take a look at Chris Sale, for example. As you can see right now, his buy now is 9,720. If we tap on over to his marketplace, you can see he was buy now price of under 9,000 yesterday on 620. If you did the sell now price, you could get him for around 6,800, close to 7K. And now he's back up to 9,720. That's a several thousand stub profit as it is. And I think he'll continue to rise for the next couple of days. If you look at him, I picked up 4 of them for around 7,000 stubs. Right now he's closing in on 10K stubs. That's a 2K profit right there. I think he gets up a couple thousand more, and I can make 3,000 to 4,000 stubs per Chris Sale card that I had. I've done that across the entire market as every card essentially was down. We can even look at a gold like JD Martinez. He went down drastically as well. You can see that dip in his market right there. He's down a couple hundred stubs too. So essentially what happens is we can predict these drops. We can predict these fluctuations in the market. We can then buy these cards while they're extremely low value in the market, sell them back a week later after they've gone up in price, and hopefully get close to double our subs back. I personally invested about $300,000-$350,000 to the market on last Friday, Saturday. I'm going to be turning that hopefully into about $500,000 or so, give or take a little bit next week. And I'm pretty excited for that. So again, that's something that you don't necessarily have to guess for, because we can predict that ahead of time. And we always talk about those here on this channel as we predict those. So definitely, if that's something you want to take advantage of, I think it's a great way to do it. One of the best things about it is you don't even have to be on your PlayStation. You can help the Show Nation, invest and buy cards on the Show Nation on your phone. If you at work have 15 minutes to go to the bathroom, pull up your phone, throw out 20-30K stubs and some investments as the market's going crazy on Friday afternoon while you're stuck at work. Boom, you can turn around and double, triple your stubs come the next week. And then the final thing I want to talk about here, I think it's something that's very, very overlooked and underrated, is inventory management. At least once a week, you need to be coming through and cleaning out your inventory of things you aren't using or are not holding for investment purposes. For example, here, as I look through, we have Ramon Urias here, and I can sell him for 95 stubs. Now, is that much? No, personally, I'm probably just gonna use him for a Team Affinity exchange. But if you're just starting out, if you don't have many stubs, 95 stubs here, 95 stubs there. You can see we have 4 Eduardo Rodriguez's, 350 stubs per piece. Now, even if you're not opening a lot of packs, stuff you're getting from free packs, daily rewards, post-game rewards, login rewards, whatever, you're going to be accumulating some cards. As you can see, I'm sitting on these cards here for investment purposes, but we can keep going through. You have Josh Taylor. He's worth 260 subs. It's not a lot, but you do that for every team. You stay on top of your inventory, going all the way down here. You know, even some commons have 8 Ben Hellers at 69 stubs apiece. That's going to be a decent little profit there. It's not going to be a ton, but couple hundred stubs here, couple hundred stubs there. We can make a couple thousand stubs per team selling stuff times 30 teams. You can make a lot of money. Now, if you really want to get crazy, you can even come through here and do the free agents as well. I probably have a dumb amount of stubs sitting here in free agent cards that I'm just holding on to because I'm too lazy to go through and sell. But you can come through here, sell your cards that you've picked up, accumulated for free over the week, and make a ton of stubs. But it doesn't end just with cards. You don't want to overlook your equipment, your sponsorships, your stadiums, and most importantly, your unlockables. A lot of people don't think about their unlockables, but as we come in here, we'll scroll through here. I have a random diamond unlockable right here. It's actually not sellable, so that one doesn't do us any good. As you can see, I got some silvers here, and these quick sell. I can go through here and I can quick sell them. They quick sell for 100 subs. So there's 300 subs right there. There would be 400 stubs on that one right there. If I find a gold one right here, we have the clown car. I can view it in the market. Actually sells for 565 stubs. So if you're sitting on a lot of those, that's gonna add up. I always tell people you have more stubs in your inventory than you think. You gotta go through and take advantage of that. Clean out your inventory, accumulate as many stubs as possible. You always want as many stubs to work with so you can invest, turn it into more stubs, do whatever you want there, complete collections, yada yada. Definitely come in here, stay on top of your inventory, sell out the cards that you're not using in your lineup, that you're not holding for an investment, or that you're not actively collecting. And by ice means sell everything, duplicates or not. I'm going through before I have collections done, and I am selling every single card that I am not using, collecting, or saving for an investment. You got to go through and you got to knock them all out. You'll do that and you'll have way more stubs than you think. So that is going to do it for today's video. A bit of a long one, but I hope it was helpful. I wanted to try to be as comprehensive as possible. If you're a veteran of the game, probably a lot of stuff that you already knew. But if you're new to the game, you're just getting into DD maybe. Maybe you just picked up the game as it was on sale in the last couple weeks. I hope you found this video very helpful. I do want to give a quick shout out to our Twitch channel real quick. Link will be down in the description below. We are live about 5 days a week on Twitch, grinding out. You can follow our progress along as a fully no money spent player, grinding out our team, grinding out the game, accumulating stubs, how we're going to be attacking the market that week. What are we investing in that week? What are my goals that week for improving my team? Where can I improve my team? Et cetera, et cetera. A lot of that stuff happening all live on Twitch. Definitely check out the link in the description. If you ever want to swing by, we have an awesome community, a lot of people super knowledgeable about the game. I can help you out with any questions you have. If you got any questions about setting up your team, your lineup, or working the market specifically, we have a ton of people that are all willing to help out there. So definitely swing by, check the link down in the description below, as well as my Twitter there too. My DMs are open, so feel free if you ever have any questions, slide up in the DMs. I may not always be super timely in my responses. Sometimes I get overloaded with quite a lot, but I do make it a point to go through and respond to everybody, no matter how big or small your question is. If you got any, hit me up on Twitter. More than happy to respond. I love interacting with all you. I love, you know, growing the community, being a part of the community. I don't want to feel like a stranger to any of y'all. You know, I'm all ears. I'm all open for anything and everything. MLB The Show related or not, I don't care. DM's fully open. Be sure to slide up in it. But it's going to do it for today's video, though. Again, a bit of a long one, so apologies there. But I hope it was informative. I'm sure there are things that I left out, so let me know down in the comment section below. What are some of your biggest tips and tricks as a no money spent guy? What have you been doing this year to really take advantage of the game? Because I am sure that there were some things that I left out that I you know, didn't hit on as much as I should. So definitely let me know down in the comment section below. And as always, if you like this video, definitely be sure to like and subscribe. We're closing in on 4,500 subs. When we hit 5,000 subs, we're going to be doing a 12-hour straight flipping challenge where I go through. We're going to get up to about 500K stubs and flip for 12 hours straight. See if maybe we can double up our stubs during that time. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to that. Definitely, it's going to be an interesting. It's going to be interesting. I'm looking forward to it, though. So definitely be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's get to 5K subs. And let's bust out that video, because that would be a heck of a good time. But until next time, I'll catch y'all around.